All right. So, hey.
Hello.
All right. Tell me your name.
Mitch Schultz.
Mitch Schultz. Mm-hmm. And what is your trail name?
My trail name is Flight Risk. And I got Flight Risk from basically Professor. My boat that I live on, a sailboat, is actually named Flight Risk. And everybody seems to think that's a cool name. So that's how I got the name Flight Risk. And that happened today.
So. the naming.
Yep.
The naming ceremony took place today. Yes, indeed. So. Yeah. So tell me, what is your inspiration for coming out on the Appalachian Trail?
So I've been hiking growing up off and on, and I've done some long trails and some small stuff, but the AT has always been out there as like the gold standard, the thing to do.
Yeah.
And so that's something that I've always wanted to do, and I think it's like such a personal challenge to overcome.
Yeah.
And I think it's something that you could really learn, grow on and do something like just, I don't know. It's just, it's like an Everest challenge, right?
An Everest challenge.
Right.
Well, so it's actually, I think statistically it's like climbing Everest 17 times, right?
I don't know, but you know, it's one of those things. It's just like, what is that stretch goal for you? And like, and can you do it? And can you, you always want to test yourself. Am I capable of making something like this happen? And so that was one of the reasons why I chose to do this.
So why now? Like, tell me the story of like, you were working and now here, like,
so
why now?
I'd been with my company for 16 years, but about 4 or 5 years ago, I noticed things changing in the company and stuff like that. When that's fine, and companies change and roles change and stuff like that. And I was trying to figure out what my next step would be with the company or my next career step would be. And I really don't have an answer for that, but I knew that there's other things that I wanted to do, and I knew I wanted to travel. And honestly, I bought a boat, a sailboat, about 8 years ago, and I moved on to it, and I've been living on board with the end goal of retiring and going and sailing around the world. And so I was thinking about, you know, I've been working towards getting that thing set up to where it's ready to go. And when I made a decision that I wanted to pull the trigger and actually start going and living instead of just working. And trust me, I mean, I had everything, a family, as far as not a wife and kids, but, you know, my family is all in town, all friends, you know, everything was there for me in Jacksonville, Florida.
Yeah.
But, you know, I just wanted something else, something more. So so once I decided that I wanted to do that, I remembered that, hey, now would be a great time to do the Appalachian Trail before I go soft sailing. So I was like, let me add this little thing on to there.
Just a small
just a
walk.
Tiny little 6 month
not
walk,
a big deal.
Walk in the woods.
Yeah,
so.
Yeah. Tell me, how old are you? Do you mind me asking?
I'm 44.
You're 44.
Mm-hmm.
And what was your job?
I was a project manager at the time for a beverage company.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. And you're a chemist, right?
I started off as a chemist, then I was running a processing department for the company, and then I went into project management to do capital expenditure projects for the company, specifically around the department that I had been running previously.
So there's a group of people who are following me, and they're generally the theme is that, you know, we're redefining our relationship with work, and you know, we don't have to be slaves to the boss all the time, right?
Yeah.
So what advice do you have for these people who were like you before you were, you know, made this big decision? What advice do you have to those people who aren't quite at that decision point but might be feeling frustrated?
So I think one of the things that always helped me and helped motivate me was I set these goals years ago, a few years ago, you know, a couple years ago. And so there's certain things that I needed to do leading up to that. And so I identified those things, whether it be a financial goal that you need to do, a physical goal that you need to do, getting things in order, whether it your living situation, whether you've got animals, family, you know, whatever it is, getting everything and having an understanding, a plan and a timeline to get to where you want to be.
Yeah.
And so I had this goal of saying like, and a lot of it was financial, but there's other things that I had said, okay, I want to be able to accomplish these different things. And like getting ready for the Appalachian Trail, you know, okay, I need to get the gear, I need to test these out, I need to go practice hike and do shakedown stuff like that, yeah. Having all that stuff built in. But ultimately having a long-term goal about like, hey, here's what I want to do. And it's something out there, like something that you're like, wow, nobody else really does this. Yeah. This is something crazy.
Yeah.
You know.
It's living.
I kind of think of it like, if you want to leave a legacy, what is that legacy that you want to leave? You
I
know,
like it.
When like, I don't have any kids, but you know, I know that my nieces and my nephews and all my family are gonna be like, oh, that's that crazy uncle. That's that guy. He did this with his life. He did that with his life. He did this. He did that. And so it's like, you know, and for me, the other thing was being with that company for so long.
Yeah.
You kind of get into this bubble where you think there is no other workout. I'm only capable of doing this.
You're right.
And
right.
You're not.
Right.
You're capable of doing whatever. So actually quitting that job was like realizing that I actually have other things that I can do.
Wow.
It was like kind of like eye-opening to me. Wow. And so many people when I quit, you know, they actually threw a little party for me and stuff at work. And they were like, you know, where I'm so impressed, I'm so proud of you, and like I wish I could do what you're doing and stuff like that. Be that person that, you know, they say I wish I could be like you.
Yeah.
You know.
Yeah, write your story.
And I'm generally, I know it doesn't seem like it, but I'm a very introverted individual. So it takes, so this is also another thing about this is helping me get out there and be more extroverted and learning how to, you know, handle adverse situations a little bit easier and better. So it's a growth opportunity as well. Don't look at it as just a challenge. Look at it as an opportunity to grow in different ways. Because there's planning that has to go into this. You day-to-day management, mental, you know, you have to stay on top of that. And then, you know, whatever inner demons everybody's dealing with, you know, everybody's got their own little thing.
We all have them.
And so it's trying to figure out how do I work through that.
That's great. That's great. All right. Yeah. Well, thanks for sharing your story. I think it's going to be inspiring to a lot of people.
Cool. Well, thank you.
There's a lot more of us than
that. Yeah. Right? It's surprising.
It's
a lot
more of us.
I'm surprised at how, when I go out and I've been out on the trail, it's been amazing that I can sit there and look at almost every single person that I've met on the trail. A, everybody's been super friendly and awesome and supportive, which is amazing. B, I look at people and I'm like, oh, that's so-and-so from my life. Oh, that's so-and-so from my life. So it's almost like they're already people you already knew. Or
yeah.
You know, they're already characters that were in your life regularly.
Yeah.
So it's like, I'm kind of like, oh, I know that guy reminds me exactly of this person. That person reminds me of that person.
That's cool.
But I think it's really cool how transferable it kind of is.
I love it.
But I think the coolest thing out here is just everybody. Like for me to come out and just spend this kind of time with people that I don't know.
Yeah.
And you have to trust immediately.
Yes.
But you all share a very common interest. It's very cool.
Yeah. You know? All right, flight risk. Nice job.
Cheers.
Thank you
so
much.
Phoenix.
Okay.